What I have here, and I think I can share it with you, is the first book, the English book, under the title of Who or What Am I? And it's a translation. The Greek edition, which already circulates in the Greek-speaking world with great success. The first book, Who or What Am I, is trying to answer the very important metaphysical question of who am I, from different perspectives. You will notice that basically it talks about, it refers to the question with two different ways, who or what am I? I recall recently I was talking about this book with a good friend of mine, and he says, why what? Well, that's the key, because everybody is thinking about who am I, everybody. But the what component of it opens up avenues for further analysis and cognitive and development of the answer from different perspectives. Okay, and in this series of small segments, I will be given the opportunity to explain what I mean. The what is very important. Let's not forget that the effort here is not to think necessarily as we think while we're fully functioning in this physical environment, in this time-space continuum. The question is to be able to cover everything that relates to creation. And in that sense, human and his thinking is an extremely minute component. So the what am I is very important, and it will become obvious later on. The who am I is as plain as it appears. It is the understanding of a human who tries to find himself or herself within a sea of energy, as an individual who is actually tries to survive, tries to separate from the environment, prove a unique presence, and also come in terms with all the complexities of this other energy that affects him, same way that he affects it. So the who am I, it is a simpler part. Now, the book itself, it is composed of three different units. The very first unit, it's a treatise of trying to explain the continuation and the connection, the relationship between science and metaphysics. For many people, these two terms appear to be very different, and they don't appear to be to have any close relationship. There is nothing more remote from the truth. The truth is, and I will explain that, and the book goes through the pain of really convincingly explain that there is a direct relationship between science and metaphysics. There will be more opportunities that I will explain it, but for the sake of this early introduction to the introduction, we have to leave it as it is. So the first unit relates to the explanation of how science and metaphysics are interrelated. The second component is the main body of the book, and tries to answer the question of what exists. Now, what exists throughout the creation is It's a very challenging question, okay? And this is the subject of the whole five books. Therefore, the next unit of the first book is actually the introduction to the rest of the books. And again, we're going to be having opportunities to talk extensively about that. But the answer of what exists overall, it is going hand to hand with the answer to the question, what am I? So it is the what that defines the context of the actual unit we are talking about. Incidentally, this particular section of the book, which is five chapters, ends up with the derivation of a model, existential model of four bodies, that it is the backbone of my thinking, and it has been proven that it is capable of explaining, assuming that you understand the model and the content, everything. It's a very simple model, but that is power, that is value. A model can be as important and as ubiquitous as simple can be. If it's not simple, it limits itself. So you have to have a model that it is simple, but you got to have the understanding, the knowledge to be able to expand it accordingly to cover all possibilities. That model does just that. The third part of the book relates to the question of who am I. It's the final four chapters of the book, and it is based in positioning into a notion which I call reality perspective. Now, reality perspective amounts to what somebody thinks of himself. And that in a combination, because there are several of them, that in a combination results into formulating the answer of each one of us with respect to the question, who am I? Incidentally, the final chapter of the book, it talks about extraterrestrials. Not because there is anything extremely important to that. As far as I'm concerned, extraterrestrials, they are everywhere. Could be us who are extraterrestrials in many different ways. It depends on the perspective. But it's a question that relates to that many people are keeping in mind. It's a sensational question. And I'm using this question to explain the value of the model. So I have purposely opted to talk about extraterrestrials in order to be able to take advantage of the model and show its value. Thank you very much. I hope you will buy the book and you will enjoy it.